go. Mic check, mic check. How you guys doing out there? What? I didn't hear you. How you guys doing out there? All right. You getting ready for it, right? Everybody's excited? All right. I can't wait, man. This is going to be a beautiful. Get more cars in here. Come on, Cadillac. Go on and keep going. Keep going. Who we got in that yellow car? I can't even read the door. There you go. Keep going. There got to be room in front of you. Oh, don't run over nobody. Yeah, there. We don't want to do that. All right. Hey, it's Juneteenth, guys. African-American Independence Day. I'm going to tell you again, 1776. 1776, when America got its freedom, they weren't thinking about y'all. They weren't thinking about us. It was 1865, almost 2.5 years after the Emancipation Proclamation, when General Gordon Granger was dispatched to Texas with his troops to announce to the last of the enslaved people that they had won their freedom. That's 2.5 years, y'all. How many of y'all gonna quit a job and work for 2 more years? How many of y'all gonna get fired from a job and just work 2 more years? Well, that's what happened. 2.5 years after the Emancipation Proclamation was signed, General Gordon Granger was dispatched to Galveston, Texas, and he announced on the 19th of June that the enslaved people had won their freedom. You know, we are the children of those who chose to survive. And I think what we're going to do is I'm going to take a break from the mic and let folks enjoy the parade. That's what I'm going to do. So I'll be back in 2 and 2. There'll be more after this.
they time for they getting curved. Huh? We out?
I said nobody messes with you.
Mayor's plan for the next 4 years here. Give me a ride back. I'll take some. Thank you. Let's see what you got. I'll take it.
Well, I'm old. You could have went halfway. Got mine back.
Once the band passes, we can do it.
What she asked?
first because we have to give homage to our ancestors and to the spirit of the drum, the ones that went before us. So we're able to do this today. If you ever think about, nobody ever thought about the drummers, how many drummers have went on and got their hands sliced off for telling the story or bringing the story. So we like to send homage to all of them. Especially to us, to one of our dear brothers, Dr. Salif. We just lost him. And we'll mention a couple more, y'all, that we're gonna go into do. So, as my homeboy would say many years ago, King Sudiata Keita, is everybody ready? Ready, ready, ready? Yeah, let's give him a round of applause, y'all. This next one we're gonna do, it's called Lamba. Check it out. Thank you. We hope you enjoyed our show, y'all. Let's give him a round of applause, y'all. Peace and love.
One more time, y'all. How y'all doing this evening? All right. Now I'm about to bring a special guest up to the stage. She's like a second mother to me, but for you guys, what's important to know is she's the founder of Juneteenth here in Flint. She started this way back when I was a little baby in the crib. I didn't even know what was going on, and I was out here in the parade doing stuff. So, with great pleasure, I'm going to introduce you guys, Ms. E. Hill Deloney. Give her a round of applause.
Harambe!
Harambe!
That's not enough. Harambe!
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 Hold it this long. Harambe! I'm getting old. I can't hold it long. Let me hear you hold it. Harambe! Come on. Don't catch a breath. Don't catch a breath. Thank you so much. I know most of you know about our Freedom School. And you know about all the days that we celebrate in our culture. The beginning of this program each year is our Youth Freedom Fund dinner. Children come in as early as preconception. When their parents are pregnant, we want them to come in because we want them to know their history and their culture and how to talk to their babies. Quite often we say things to our babies we don't think they're going to remember, but they are born with greatness. We are the one who are born with their greatness. We got to stop doing that. At the Freedom School dinner on the 16th, the beginning of Juneteenth, we recognized our children. Some of the awards were given out that night, but two were not. I'd like to ask Ms. Gracie Hunter and Mr. Darrell Luther Evans to come to the podium, please. While they're coming, Gracie has been in Freedom School since she's in the fourth grade, and she just graduated on June the 16th. Come on, everybody, give her a hand. She is going off to college with a double major, medicine, and to become a lawyer. She has been in so many things. She took 5 years to finish high school by going to early college so she'd be grounded and ready and core, ready to run. She plans to take her 4 years of college and finish in 2 years, and she's also planning to go into the Army and let the United States help pay for it. Ms. Hunter, would you come to the podium? Forgot my glasses, so I'm going to read what I think I wrote. Flint Odyssey House Incorporated, African Culture Education Development Center, Freedom School, recognizes Gracie Hunter for her 5 years as a Freedom School representative as a juror on the 67th District Court teen jury, June 16, 2015. Come around and sing. Okay, there you go. Now, all you children, young people, sorry about that. When you get in the ninth grade, we have two programs that are part of the Freedom School. Freedom School starts from birth until 25, but when you graduate, when you get in the ninth grade, we have the AXO program that is started with the NAACP. There are 26 categories, and if you participate in that, you can get scholarships to college, you can get technology schools, you can do a whole lot of things. So we invite you to start in Freedom School as a young child, continue through AXO, African Culture, Education, and Development. The next program from ninth grade to 12th grade would be the one that Ms. Hunter just got honored for 5 years. She can only get in there when she's in the ninth grade, but she stayed in through the fifth year of her high school education. The next person we're honoring is Darrell Luther Evans. Luther did not miss one session of court in 2014 and 2015. So we want to congratulate him and thank him so very much. His plaque reads, thank you, Flint Odyssey House Incorporated, African Culture Education Development Center, Freedom School, recognizes Darrell Raymond Luther Evans for his commitment and service as a Freedom School representative to teen jury and never miss serving as a juror during the 25th court session, June 16, 25. Okay, come around and get a picture. Shake your hand. Come this way. I did, look at your granddad. He wants to take it. Okay. When you just said the seven Harambes, most of you may not have known what it means. Harambe means pulling together. And we need to pull together not only in our community, but if we start in our community, the most important person that you need to pull together with is who? Who? I want to hear. Self. You got to start with self. What you're just playing out here is what's on the outside, but it came from you. In Freedom School, we teach you to get to know who you are, how precious you are. Look in the mirror and say, look at your eyes and talk to yourself. Get the stuff out that the world has taught you in America about yourself. Get to accept yourself. You are a precious human being, and you need to start loving yourself and accepting yourself. We too often don't do that, and that's why we hurt each other. In Freedom School, we have a mantra. I'm going to repeat the mantra. I'm going to ask you to follow me again once. It has 5 points. I know me. You're not talking about the other person. You don't know them. I know me. I accept me. I don't want to be you. You're a person you need yourself. I want to be me, the best me I can be. I love me. If I don't love me, I can't love you. When I make a mistake, if I hurt you, I ask you to forgive me. But I need to ask myself to forgive me and let that stuff go. Don't carry around being angry with somebody for 20 years. You've forgotten what they did to you, but you're still angry. And the last part, know that a higher power lives within you. So, follow me. I know me. Let's do it again. I want to hear it. I know me. I accept me. I love me. I forgive me. A higher power lives within me. I know you. I accept you. I love you. I forgive you. A higher power lives within you. We know each other. We accept each other. We love each other. We forgive each other. A higher power lives within me. Now we're going to close with our mantra. And I want everybody to just bring that out of them. And I want to see the power sign fully and available. I know me. I accept me. I love me. I forgive me. A higher power lives within me. Okay, I want to say a hand up that's hearing me and say, Harambe! Thank you and have a good evening. Enjoy from now until the 21st. This year we're including Father's Day so we can honor the fathers. Thank you so much.
Give it up for the Queen Mother. Come on now. That's the founder of Juneteenth. Had she not started it, had I not seen them driving down the road, we wouldn't be here right now. Give it up one more time, Mrs. E. Hill Deloney. Man, what are we going to do now? We had a parade that was fabulous. Wasn't the parade fabulous? We've had entertainment that was wonderful. Wasn't entertainment wonderful? We had a couple of poets that did it right. Wasn't that great? We even had Brother Elliot McCants down here bringing the message. That was wonderful. I guess we're done. Good night, everybody. I'm lying. It ain't over. It's just beginning. Sound man, put on a little music while we get our stage entertainment up and ready to excite you and entertain you and let you know what it's like to be here in Flint, Michigan. It's Juneteenth, y'all. Mom and Dad, all the good I do is for you. Give it up again. That was wonderful. Wonderful. You know, I don't even know the name of the band. What's the name of the band? Who? Send somebody up here to talk to me. Come on now. Come on, come on, come on. Run, 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 run. They did too good a job. We got to give them some credit. I like that. I like that. Come on up here, baby. Tell them who you are.
We're Nightfire Drumline. We're Independent Drumline. We make up various schools around Flint, northern, central, northwestern, southwestern.
All right, wait a minute. He got to catch his breath. We're going to give him a chance to catch his breath because he's got to give out a phone number. And what you guys got to do is you got to pull out a pen, a piece of paper, or your cell phones, and you need to lock this number in because they need to be doing stuff around Flint. You agree? You agree? I love you guys. Stand by. Go ahead, baby.
You can get in touch with Clarence Ruffin, 810-877-4887, or Shari Rosborough, 810-240-6834.
All right. Is that the card I need? Yeah. Thank you, brother. You guys did a wonderful job. You did us proud. One more time for the drumline, y'all. All right. Is the mayor in the house, Dane Walling? Head to the stage. Fire, head to the stage. If you are in the house, we need you at the stage. It's African American Independence Day, y'all. Juneteenth. Hey, how many of y'all got cell phones out there? Hold your cell phone up if you got a cell phone. Come on now, hold them up, let me see them. Hold that cell phone up. All right, I need you to bring it down and I need you to hit redial. Hit redial, whoever answers the phone, you tell them to get down here. Last person you talk to need to be here. Tell them to come on, it's Juneteenth. All right, without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the mayor of the city of Flint, Dane Walling.
All right. Well, happy Juneteenth, everyone. Let's give a big round of applause to all the amazing organizers and leaders in this community who have made this great event possible. Let's give them a big round of applause. We had a wonderful time in the parade. We came up over the hill right here, and it looked like we had an old-fashioned block party of people in Flint getting together. That's an appropriate way to celebrate. Right. Oh, it's because we got, since we got two speakers going right now, I'll go ahead and let you know that Riverbank Park is under a $400,000 improvement and is not available all summer while we make sure that park is secured for generations to come. What we're here to do today is celebrate African American Independence Day. And some people, especially our younger people, may not know this because it's not taught in the history books, that we're celebrating today because it took from the announcement of the Emancipation Proclamation until the summer for slaves all across this country to learn about their freedom. Now, we're in a very different era today. Today, news travels around the globe in an instant. And unfortunately, that means that incidents like those that took place in Charleston immediately affect all of us. And I'd just like to ask, if I could, to take a moment for us to give a moment of silence for those victims, those saints who were lost in Charleston. The struggle continues, and there continues to be work to be done. We're going to continue to do it right here in Flint, from the north side to the south side, the east side to the west side. We've got to come together. It doesn't take away from the challenges we face, but I believe deeply that we're bigger than our challenges, that we're better than the issues that confront us. And if we stick together, and if we stand together, and work together, then we're going to continue to see great progress in this community, not just for one part of town, but for the entire community, not just for my neighborhood, but for your neighborhood, and for people of all colors and all ages, and indeed all faiths. So with that, happy Juneteenth. May God bless, continue to bless the city of Flint and all of you.
Good looking, Dane. Thanks a lot for your contribution as well as what you do, all right? So now, here, if there are any more food vendors out there that want to bribe me with free food, I am willing to take it because we got a brother over here doing corn on the cob and it is on jam. Make sure you check out Brother Leonard. Let me put this down before I embarrass myself. Might be too late. All right. Where's Fire at? Fire, where you at, girl? You're supposed to be up here. Chi-Town, this might be your chance, baby. Come on down. First one I see gets it. First one I see. Also looking for Kevin Collins and the African Drum and Dance Troupe. Where you be? Where you be? It's Juneteenth, guys. African American Independence Day. A time to reflect and rejoice. Remember, we are the children of those who chose to survive. Do you feel me? We are the children of those who chose to survive. Remember, they came to the continent of Africa and they stole our kings and queens. They put them in the hulls of ships across the Middle Passage where we died in countless numbers. Those that survived that passage landed on the shores of America into this peculiar institution known as slavery. The only harsh and unrelenting slavery in the world. Even after the Emancipation Proclamation, we were still first hired, last fired, or first fired, last hired. We still had to deal with dogs and water hoses and all sorts of discrimination. Couldn't buy a house where you wanted to. Couldn't get a job when you needed one. It was tough. But because you're here, because you can hear my voice, you need to be proud of your ancestors. You know, I think about my great-great-great-great-great-grandmother all the time, though I never met her. I think about my great-great-great-great-grandfather all the time, but I never met him. Merely knowing that my parents existed tell me that they were great people, that they survived a great struggle, that they dealt with great hardships, that they allowed me to be here today. If it wasn't for them and their struggles, I wouldn't be here. Maybe y'all wouldn't be here. It's African American Independence Day, guys. We are the children of those who chose to survive. And one of my other, I gotta tell you this, it ain't easy being green. We got a lot of people doing a lot of things, and there's so much going on, and we want to participate in everything. And that's good, because if there is nothing going on, we complain. We got the Unity Parade tomorrow. We got Saints on a plane tonight at the McCree Theater, and we're going to be here, right here in University Square until 9:30 tonight. And we want to invite you guys to stay with us, because we got a lineup of entertainment that's going to impress. I need to know if fire's in the house. Where is fire? Chi-Town Mac, you're missing your spot. All right. Well, I guess what we got, where's Kevin? I thought I saw him coming this way. I saw Kevin Collins in the house. All right. Well, let's see, first one I see gets it. All right, I see Chi-Town coming over to the soundboard. We might get to hear the No Future in the new anthem for Flint. Is that what you're telling me, Chi? You got a new anthem for Flint? You guys give it up for Chi-Town Mac.
What's up, Flat City? What's up? I said, what's up?
It's been a long time. I ain't new to this, I'm true to this. Bree, big cousin, yeah. Let me get some. Turn me up a little bit. A little louder. They got to feel this one. Come on. Hey, music man. Stop me up one more time. I got to be right. I got to be right. They expect the rightness. Hey. All right now. Brand new anthem. Check it. Speed limit 35, rolling with the windows down, trying to catch the summer breeze that's rolled through Flint town. Hit the nutty nook, I'm on the dirty south. I got some homies out in Beecher, go and check them out. Barbecue up on the west side of Tennessee. Come through with the brews, grab something to eat. I'm on the west side, chilling when the phone rang. It's the east side, homie doing his own thing. Plans change, I do a lane change. Got girls doing strange things for the change. Step in like a T-Pain or Lil Wayne. Soon as I step up in the thing, man, I make it rain. Got them going insane, they don't complain. All know my name, and they glad I came. Now I'm out this thing, Southside I ain't. Hip feel, keep it real, going to King's Lane. Wanna go where everybody knows my name. Screaming out, Godfather, he ain't changed. See, I'm a little bit older, man. I'm colder, world on my shoulders, and I won't stop. I ain't gonna quit, I'ma blow it in the air while I roll through Flint. Speed limit 35, rolling with the windows down, trying to catch the summer breeze roll through Flint town, the city where beauty runs low. And if you ever shoot through my city, now you know. We ain't strictly business and we also got a pride. And if you don't like it, I suggest you break it wide. It's F-A-Live for life. I put it on the kids and wife. It's F-A-Live for life. F-A-Live for life. You come to here, boy, you better be right. Motorcycle shined up with the helmet to match. Saddleback, pack colors, one on their back. By the motorcycle clubs in the city of Flint. And they gonna represent on every corner this bitch. Now the speed limit's 35, but let me loose. I be on a ninja rolling like my homeboy Toots. Like Toots, whoosh, I'm off in the wind. Like a bullet out the chamber, you won't see me, my man. From Flint, where I'm Clyde wrote they boogie down. Sagging all the eagles be riding around. Past the hammer droppers, baby, where them drifters at? Seen a couple of new members outside the set. I watched street riders while they did they tricks. Haters stood around, man, looking sick. I scream, swagnificent, never in the city of Flint. Flint, Bronx, Merc City, yeah, we all up in this. Speed limit 35, got the windows down, trying to catch the summer breeze, roll to Flint town, the city, where beauty runs low. If you ever shoot through the city, now you know. We ain't strictly business, and we also got a pride. If you don't like it, we suggest you break wide. It's ever live for life, ever live for life. I put it on the kids and wife, it's ever live for life. For life, for life. You come through here, boy, you better be right. It's ever life, for life. I put it on my kids and wife. It's ever life, for life. It's ever life, for life. Don't make me have to tell your butt twice. Motorcycle shined up. Helmet with the match. Now what's up? Ever life, for life. Throw the phones up. If you ever life, for life, this where you at? Throw your hands up. Are y'all gonna rep y'all city? What? Speed limit 35, rolling with the windows down. You can find Godfather anywhere up in this town of Chi-Town, Mac player. Mr. Hands in the air. See there, be there, I'm there, we there. F and Lion T here, other cities see here. Chi-Town Mac, throw the party, all you cities be here. We gon' do it that M-I-C style. H-I-G-N-E, yeah, yeah, we wild. Spittin' by the middle, no B-S, Evolve Party, mini exhibition, yeah, boy, we goes hard. Drink good, smoke good, all cities, all hood. Chi-Town Mac, the Godfather, love for the mix does ride. If a lie for life, if a lie T.O.G.'s.
What do you guys think about our new location here at University Square? I like it. I kind of like it. It gives it that street festival kind of vibe, right? We like downtown, but I like this a lot. I like this a lot. You know, I got a lot of quotes that I like, and my favorite one is from Booker T. Washington. You guys know who Booker T. is, right? Old school, old school. And what Booker T said, he said, in all things purely social, and you know what I mean by social, if I want to play basketball or play baseball or play football or go do horseshoes or cross-country skiing, social things, dancing, partying, hanging out at the clubs, in all things purely social, and I'm telling you again, I can go skiing, I can go water skiing, jet skiing, there's a whole variety of social things I can do. He says, in all things purely social, we can be as separate as the fingers, y'all. And that means if I want to go play football, I want to play with people that play football. If I want to go skiing, I want to ski with people that ski. If I want to do horseshoes, I want to play horseshoes with people that play horseshoes. So in all things purely social, we can be as separate as the fingers. But we gotta be one, y'all. We gotta be one like the hand in all things that are beneficial to our mutual progress. You feel me? Now, when I'm talking about our mutual progress, I'm talking about grocery stores in the black neighborhood. When I'm talking about mutual progress, I'm talking about educating our babies. When I'm talking about mutual progress, I'm talking about cooperative economics. I need to know how many entrepreneurs we got out in the audience. By a show of hands. Kev, when you're ready, just tell me, baby. I'm stalling. By a show of hands, how many entrepreneurs do we have? All right, I got one. Come on down here, baby. Who else we got? Who else we got? We only got one entrepreneur. Come on, baby. Come on, you too. Is that all we got? We only got two business owners out of all these folks? You know, we can't support you if we don't know where you are. Now, I'm not saying you have to be legal, but you got to be legit. You hear me? So if you're doing hair in the basement, you're doing nails, you're selling that Avon, maybe you're doing that Shackley thing or that Zango juice. Maybe you're changing tires. You're a shade tree mechanic, baby. I need one of them. What if you're doing State Farm? I could use an insurance agent. You know what I need? I need somebody to do these toes. Do we got anybody doing toes? Because I got some monster toes here that need some help. I'm looking for you. I want to spend my money with you. So where are my entrepreneurs?